Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Pillars are commonly paired with cobots to increase their range. Let's see how you can create your own custom vertical axis in RoboDK. Let's get started. For this example, let's open 06A linear rail and pillar, and let's open the Omron TM example here. Perfect. So in this example here, we have a conveyor bringing in boxes, we have a pallet, and we have a pillar or a linear or vertical range extender. So it's composed of three parts. You have the base here, you have kind of a middle section, and you have the top section on which the robot lies. So if you want to test this range extender, just start by opening the Python folder here and double click on range extender midsection. And then you can double click the base here. And if you were to move the linear rail in any direction, the midsection would follow. So I'm going to show you how this works exactly. So here, let's start by just showing you this project in action. So I'm going to bring in boxes, and you'll see that from layer to layer, the pillar will bring the robot upward, making sure that the boxes are always in range, or the position to drop the boxes are always in range. Cool, perfect, and just like that, and so on and so forth. Perfect, so I'm gonna stop that by pressing escape. I'm gonna close this station here. I'm gonna save that file as here, and I'm gonna save this here under linear rail pillar, perfect. So I'm gonna reuse that later. Let's close this here, and don't save anything, perfect. So to create a pillar, like the one you saw, you need to create a linear axis, obviously. But as you can imagine, and from the experience we had in the last video, there's no way to add the midsection of the pillar. But I found a clever way to do it, and I hope you will enjoy, because like I said, there's no official way, but I kind of found a way, and I want to share it with you. So let's start by creating here. Now let's start by bringing in our three sections of our range extender. So we have range extender mid, top, and base. So I'm going to bring all of that inside RoboDK. I already positioned them properly, so I would recommend you to do so and make sure that they are in three different pieces. Perfect. So the next thing I'll do is create a frame right on top here. So I'm going to go here and tool, measure. I'm going to select this midsection here, copy that frame. We're gonna call that frame base, and here double click on it and paste the value we just found. Perfect. Here, that's cool. So now we have Z axis pointing upward, X in front, and Y to the side. You might wondering now, you might think that it won't work, because if I don't have the X axis pointing in the same direction as the rail motion, it will give me some weird behavior. So I do agree with you, but I'm going to show you a little something at the same time. So if you go utilities and model mechanisms or robot, let's start with the linear rail. So let's start with the most important part of this rail here, which is the top section with respect to the base. The midsection is more for aesthetic purposes. At the end of the day, it's nothing more than that, but the other two sections here are more important, as they're the one carrying the robot around. So let's call that range extender, and now I go base frame, perfect. The base will be the base, and here none will be here extender one. I should have called that top, to be honest. And minimum will be zero. I don't want it to go lower, and let's say we'll go for 2 meter. I don't know exactly how much I need. So if I go here and I select update, and I try to move the robot around, I'm gonna make that a bit lower, smaller. I'm gonna hide this here, or no, in fact, I won't. If I move that here, as we could expect, it's not moving in the right direction whatsoever. So it's moving like in the same direction as the x-axis. So that's true. That's if you have a linear rail moving on the ground, let's say. But if you have a vertical one, what you can do is simply remove the 90 degree rotation here. So that's the base shift with respect to the motion. So you're just removing a rotation of 90 degrees. Like I said, in a future video, I'll explain it in more details. But if you want just an X, a Z axis motion, you can just remove everything here. And if you click update here, now it's moving in the right direction. But as you can see here on top, you need to also remove the rotation here. So move here. And now I have a motion along the Z axis. So that those are just transformation matrix. I don't want to give you a mathematical class on maths tonight or today, sorry. But yeah, at some point we will cover all of those transformations. So H, in this case, it's HB to H0 and then so on and so forth. And here it's HT. So from H6, which is, or depending on how many joints you have, if you had a robot, a six axis robot, it will be between H6 and HT. Yeah. Anyway. So now we have this moving up and down. So that's great, but that's just half the project. So here, 2 meters seems a bit much. So I'll go for only one. That makes a bit more sense. Cool. So that's the first section and I can click OK on this one. Now let's go for the second one. So tools and then a utility, sorry, model, mechanism and robot. Let's call it range extender mid. I will remove this one here, remove this one here too. For the joint, so the position, the one that we want, oops, that we want to move, it will be the mid-range one here. And we want nothing for the base, because in this case, we just want to have a linear rail that moves up and down. And here is zero, and I will add 600 here. I want to have just a bit more than half the travel I have for this one, in fact. If I click update, just like that here, I now have another axis that comes here. But if you were, oops, I didn't use the right frame here. I need to use this one, update, perfect. I need to use the frame base, the same one as the beginning. Here, I have exactly what I wanted, but the only thing that needs to be done now is to synchronize those two external axes. And this is where a small Python macro comes in very handy. So if you look at the Python macro I have here, range extender midsection, if I open it up, let's say in VS Codium, so that you can see what it does. It will ask you to define the name of two range extender or two mechanisms. So here, range extender, I have the same exact syntax and same exact syntax here. So what it will do, pretty much, it will, at a using a very high refresh rate, I could even lower that down, but it's just 0.5 here, so it's even faster. Need to add the Python interpreter. Anyway, the point is that every time it will refresh very often and it will always apply half the value of height that the first or main range extender or pillar has. It will apply half of that value to the midsection. So if I was to bring just that here, and if I was to run that here, press play. Here it's a while one loop, so it's a while through, so it's always kind of stuck here. And now if I move my, let's say, main range extender, the one to the middle or the mid one, I'm gonna hide here this, I'm gonna hide the robot flange. I'm going to remove everything here so that you don't see those here. I will frame, flange, tool frame. I just need this one. I'm gonna make this one invisible. So now that everything is invisible. So now if I move the main flange here, the other one is always following like this here. So if I was to start that up, I could simply, in this case, I'm gonna stop that here. So I'm getting this one here, bring that one here. And if I double click on it, it will start running and it will be kind of updating the position of the midsection at all time. So what I did for the example I gave you before, which is this one here. So in the init here, I'm just starting as a thread. So remember, run is when we use a thread. So it will be running even if it will be running to the side. So I run my range extender midsection Python script from the beginning, just after my init, everything is clean. So starting from that point on, the midsection will be at half the value of the higher section. So if I was to run this one here and show the midsection, if I show it here, you can see if I go to 304, it's 152. If I go to 1000, it's 500, and it's following like that. There's a small lag, but to be honest, if you don't pay pretty close attention to that specific point, you won't ever see it. Okay, so that's pretty much everything for this video. In the next one, we'll explore how you can create conveyors from scratch. So honestly, it's a linear rail, this one too, so it won't be a big difference, but still, I want to cover it with you. So see you in the next video, and have a great day, guys.